Hello and welcome to the Lord Jaraxxus guide from learntoplaywow.com. Lord Jaraxxus uses a multitude of spells and, at first, the fight may seem a bit confusing. You'll probably need to see this video a couple of times in order to be able to better identify certain spells and debuffs. First off, Fell Fireball. This spell can be interrupted, so have one or two players dedicated to interrupting. These players should always stay on the boss to make sure the Fell Fireball gets interrupted. In case an interrupt gets missed, the dot effect on the tank can be dispelled. As with almost any encounter, ranged should try to stay spread out. Fell Lightning will jump from target to target otherwise. Also, you should notice and stay away from the patches of Fell Fire on the floor. These patches are actually made by players who have the Legion Flames debuff on themselves. When a player gets the Legion Flames debuff, he will be pouring patches of fire underneath himself. These patches of green fire stack up in damage and they affect anyone standing in them, so it is best if the player with the debuff quickly starts to move, preferably towards less crowded areas. Tanks also need to pay attention to the patches of green fire as, when a melee gets the Legion Flames debuff, even if the melee moves away from the group, the patches will still remain on the floor, and thus the tank needs to move himself and Jaraxxus a bit further. This will minimize the fire damage that the other melees might take. Infernals appear out of the summoned volcanoes. Stay away from these volcanoes. The Infernals do an AoE attack around them and thus melee should let ranged DPS take them out. If the ranged can't seem to get them down fast enough and too many Infernals gather up, then the melees can join in the fight as long as they are quick enough to move out of the way when they see the Infernals channeling AoE. Besides summoning Infernals, the boss will also summon a Mistress of Pain. Just like the Infernals, the Mistress needs to be off-tanked and DPS'd as soon as possible. Tanks should be quick to taunt the Mistress as she can one-shot DPS. Jaraxxus uses a self-buff called Nether Power. This buff stacks and makes Jaraxxus hit with his spells harder and harder. Thus, it needs to be dispelled. Any player that can dispel should dispel. Mages are particularly effective as they can spell steal Nether Power. Healers should take notice of Incinerate Flash. On 25 men, the target of Incinerate Flash will absorb 60k healing. So why heal it when it absorbs the heal? Well, because if you don't heal the required amount within 15 seconds, then the entire raid will take even more damage. It is possible to heal through the 5-second dot damage following a failed Incinerate Flash. But, since the damage is on the entire raid, it is dangerous because, if a player also takes damage from another source, then he is likely to die. In order to deal with Incinerate Flash, healers can rely on the default raid warning, named player has Incinerate Flash, heal him. This works if they know everybody's names and their corresponding positions within their raid frames. However, as a raid healer, you mostly keep your eyes on the raid unit frames. So, another way to approach this is to look out for the debuff. Even the default Bliss frames shows what debuffs players have. Unfortunately, there will be tons of different debuffs popping in and out on all the players. Thus, quickly spotting the right one may prove tricky. The Incinerate Flash debuff looks like this. This has been a guide from learntoplaywow.com. Thanks for watching.